Greetings. As a matter of fact, Pakistan has a tremendous youth, and in contemporary scenario, they have 16 years of education. Nevertheless, they are facing unemployment due to great number and high competition. Therefore, today we are going to talk about the foreign-funded scholarship opportunities abroad. These can be hunted via two routes, one HEC, Higher Education Commission, and second one is the direct route. There is a high competition through HEC since they take their own test and everybody rushes towards such opportunities, while searching for direct scholarships is a little bit lethargic and exhausting. However, this too is achievable. So if we talk about these opportunities, first of all, USA comes to our mind, and for that we can win a Fulbright scholarship, and the links for all these opportunities are also given. And there is also a central system through which we can search for the scholarships and universities, and we can filter according to our own choice. And next is Australia, and for that there are two kind of opportunities available. One is Australian Development Award for Pakistan for Masters and PhD, while the other one is hunting a PhD opportunity through a paid doctorate and postdoctorate degree. Same is the case for Germany through DART program for Masters, PhD. We can win a scholarship, or otherwise we can search for an opportunity that is paid doctorate and postdoctorate. For UK, Commonwealth Scholarship is available, and Chenwang is also available, and there are many other scholarships like Erasmus Mundus and other opportunities are available. For Hungary, we can win Stipendium Hungaricum through Higher Education of Pakistan, but at PhD level we need a recommendation letter from a certain university, and for that we have to send them emails to the professors who have relevant work experience to ours. And for Netherlands, the link is also given to grab the opportunities to hunt out those. And for Japan, GREPS kind of system is available, and through which we can search opportunities. And for China, there is also a central system through which we can win and grab masters, doctorate and postdoctorate opportunities. Similarly, for South Korea, France, Canada, there are many links available on internet through which we can win the opportunities. Now we are coming towards our main and key point of focus, and that is what documents are required at the time of applying abroad. So generally speaking, very few kind of documents are required, and those is that your degrees. So get your degrees and testimonials attested by Higher Education Commission timely, because it is a bit time taking process, and some of the universities ask you for HEC verified or attested degree. And secondly, you must have scanned copy of those documents as well, because nowadays many of the universities are offering online system to upload the degrees. So that is why even you can scan those degrees through your CAM scanner of your mobile phone. So next is letters of recommendation. These matter a lot, and at least two good kind of letters of recommendations, one from university professor and other from your employer, or both from your university professor, might be required. So they must seem genuine and authentic, and they must be seem realistic. They shouldn't be like an written in an ideal approach. Some of your weaknesses that do not harm your profile or personality, those must be mentioned in your letters of recommendation. And the very next is letter of motivation or study purpose. So you should also make a clear kind of letter of motivation or study purpose for which you are going to opt for. And in Pakistan, as we have to maintain our synopsis, we have to make those for securing admission or after securing admission in masters or PhD. But for those countries like developed countries, we need it before time, and that is a research plan, a research proposal that what you are going to do. And we will also have a detailed video on it. And for research proposal, research plan, this is just like the summary of your synopsis. So medical fitness certificate, police clearance certificates, IELTS or TOEFL as a language test, and GRE, graduate record exam, sometimes these examinations are also required. So the few of the links which are very beneficial for you and for all of these countries, because many of the countries have initiated the central system through which you can search and hunt your opportunities or your concerned degree or concerned university or institute. So these are given, and stay tuned to this channel and keep subscribing. So stay blessed. Wish you very best wishes for your future endeavors.